What makes Dobermans a great pet? I would say their intelligence. They're really trainable. They are, I believe, the only breed ever created specifically for personal protection.
I'm Patrick O'Connor. This is my wife, Lorna. We breed under the name Incredible Dobermans in Santa Rosa, California.
My name is Gerald Antoine. I'm from Jackson, Mississippi. I've been living in California since 1994 now.
This is Linda Calamia, and I'm the owner of Adlercrest Dobermans in Riverside, California.
The breed is just over 100 years old. It was developed by Louis Doberman.
It's around 1880 in the town of Apalda. It's in the region of Thuringia, Germany. Louis Doberman was the town dog catcher, and he was also the town tax collector. He wanted a dog to take with him on his rounds and protect him from any would-be robbers. And he had plenty of dogs to choose from since he also ran the dog pound. Different regions had different dogs that developed into breeds. In this area, there was the butcher's dog, which would be the ancestor to the Rottweiler. It was a black and tan dog. There was also the old German Shepherd, not the modern variety we see now. There was a German Pinscher. Pinscher means terrier in German. And then people say there could be a little Weimaraner. At a later date, it's known that they introduced the Greyhound into the mix. With selective breeding, in a very short time, they were breeding true to type.
Now, the Doberman is not a healthy breed. It has a really small gene pool, and they're high maintenance.
The standard of the breed is very specific. They describe the ideal Doberman male as between 26 and 28 inches at the withers, and the weight usually around 80 to 90, 95 pounds. A female is 24 to 26 inches. Weight usually around 60 to 70 pounds.
The lifespan is probably 10 to 12 years. If I get 12 years out of my dogs, I'm doing good.
I've been training since 1972. We specialize in social issues, fear and aggression. So with a Doberman, they're so tuned in to what their owner wants. I don't think there's very many breeds that are more intelligent than the Doberman. They've got to have a somewhat active lifestyle. You do not want a bored Doberman because they will find something to do.
So they can be quite aggressive when they want to. So you do have to watch for that. Usually bitches are better with each other. But then again, when bitches have a problem, the fights are going to be much worse. And you're probably going to have a big problem with that.
The temperament, the willingness to work. They never really walk nowhere. They run everywhere. You'll never see a Doberman walk unless you're walking with him.
The Doberman was bred as a personal protection dog, and he feels his job in life is to stick like glue to you, and no one's going to be out to get you. You get up and go to the bathroom, he follows you right in there. He won't leave you alone.
They keep me very active outdoors. I go hiking with them. I go bike riding with them. My dogs will always love me no matter what type of day it was. Rainy, sunshine, bad day, broke day, rich day, payday. With that being said, you get as much out as you put in.
If you have a dog that's very protective of you, you have to understand how he thinks and not put him in a situation that's going to get him in trouble, because it's not his fault that he's trying to protect you.
But if you're going to get a Doberman, you get a Doberman to do things with it, to have it be part of your life, go where you go and do what you do.